Recent reports indicate that dozens of people in Karamoja sub-region are dying from starvation and lack of food. The most affected districts are Kotido, where 107,700 are estimated to be starving, Napak 81,800, Kabong 70,600, and Moroto District 61,900. Leaders in the region have attributed the situation to a number of factors.
Insecurity started filtering into Karamoja. People started losing their livestock, which is the biggest asset. Over the last 15, 20 years, there was no World Food Program in Karamoja. Why? Because people were able to rely on their livestock, selling their goats, selling their cattle, selling their sheep. But because of the onset of insecurity since 2017, and to worsen during the COVID time when we went to the lockdown in 2020.
There have been locusts invading Karamoja is one of the reasons. Then the other thing is we also had the armyworms that have been invading Karamoja. And now insecurity invading Karamoja.
Even when government opened other institutions, the cattle markets remained closed. When the cattle markets are closed, and that is where our people sell their cows, sell their what, it devalued, the closure period devalued the cost, the value of our cows. That means our people were only relying on black markets to sell for their living.
Center for Food and Adequate Living Rights, SEFROTH Executive Director David Kamanda, however, says lack of clear food systems is largely to blame for this mess.
System in this country whatsoever to either warn you about the calamity when it comes to food, to either help you access food, to either make sure that the food is available to you. And many people are just eating. They pick whatever they find, so long as it can go into their stomach. So we do not have a food system. And when I talk about a food system, I'm talking about the process that starts from the farm to your fork.
Government has earmarked 135 billion shillings to deal with the Karamoja hunger crisis, but before this, members of the public and the new political party dispatched food relief items to Karamoja. However, Kamanda believes there needs to be safety precautions to this food relief.
Coming from a history where some Karamojans, people in Karamoja, have died in some recent past. You remember what happened in 2020 when food was distributed to people in Karamoja and they died. Why can't we have a system where the people in Karamoja can be able to grow their own food? It is very possible if government decided to do it.
Much as the Karamoja leaders called for external support to rescue their people from this calamity, SEFROTH recommends otherwise.
When a small thing has happened, they cry. We know how to be resilient. Mm. By the time we cry, it is serious. Okay. We need to be rescued.
Food is tested to make sure that we have inspectors of these food warehouses, of these food markets, of the restaurants, be it big hotels. So it is, yes, Karamoja is highlighting the issue, but it is not only an issue for the people in Karamoja. It is an issue for everyone in Uganda. And don't be safe where you are. For us at SEFROTH, we are already warning you, because what we do not have in this country is a warning system. We do not have, we would actually be seeing Office of the Prime Minister giving us weekly updates.
Access to affordable and healthy food is every Ugandan's right, which the government ought to respect by establishing national food reserves to provide food to citizens even amidst calamities.
Killed too many people in terms of when people eat unsafe food. Now, the government must come in because they have the mandate, but they also have they have the capacity to make sure that the food is tested, to make sure that we have inspectors of these food warehouses, of these food markets.
The famine in Karamoja has been attributed to a back-to-back glut of problems, low crop yields due to locust invasion, followed by prolonged drought and floods, COVID-19 disruptions and an explosion of insecurity reportedly fanned by cattle rustlers. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.